Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynut and welcome back to XCOM 2 in our Commander playthrough. Operation Doombreaker is ready to go, and then in that mission we're gonna neutralize a target hiding in an advent vehicle. We're bringing along Vinny with his EMP rounds, Christophe with of course his critical boosted shard gun, storm gun, that's what I wanted to say, storm gun. Then Humongous with a gas bomb and a medkit. Of course, Ulrich, Edel, Vryer with an EMP bomb, two grenades and armor-piercing rounds. Then we have Yang with an incendiary bomb. Actually, is that two incendiary bombs? Not really sure. Maybe I should put it like that. I'm gonna swap those out, so give me... Oh, even better. I'm gonna put the normal grenade there and then the acid bomb in her secondary, well, not her secondary slot, her grenade slot, so that is doubled normally. I think she has the heavy ordnance perk as well. So that's her loadout along with an extra vest. And then Emma Hill, our new specialist, our new hacker, ready for duty with a grenade and a skulljack. So here we go. So we're gonna get quite a bit of supplies and a bit of intel if we complete this well, successfully, and take out that target. But first we need to get there, of course. Here we go.
The spokesman has sent word of an alien collaborator moving through this area in an advent transport. Apparently the loss of this individual would be a serious blow to the aliens. So we're moving in to take care of him. Locate the transport vehicle and neutralize the VIP along with any hostile resistance. They prefer we bring the target in alive. Use whatever means necessary.
So again, as with the previous time we had this, we only get the intel if we actually capture the enemy VIP. If we kill it, we only get the supplies. So shouldn't be that hard. We've seen the amount of enemies, should be only 9 enemies. And with between Vinny's EMP rounds and Yang and Ulrich's grenades, that should work out perfectly. So it seems we're starting at the top of a building again.
Target location confirmed. Move to engage. Eliminate all hostile contacts.
Doesn't look like it's that far away, actually. Well, you guys have seen this setup for... Ooh. Is that... Yeah, so an Andromedon and 2 Vipers right near the target vehicle. So we know 3 out of the 9 enemies already where they are. So you've seen this setup quite a bit. So I'm just gonna skip right to the action. So see you guys in a minute.
Hostile targets inside.
And with a minute, I mean the very first action I take, we see the enemy. But I'll set this up and I'll get back to you. So we're pretty much where we wanna be. So I'm just gonna move Ulrich up to that full cover on the corner here, hoping that he doesn't trigger anything else. And then fire his first grenade right in this bunch of enemies. Do want to be careful that I don't destroy too much cover as I usually do, but I think this should be fine, although I do keep, yeah, I want to keep that back row open. So let's do it like this. Ulrich with the start again. Grenade in the mag and boop. There we go. Most of the armor shredded. The mech seems to be almost dead. The officer still has a lot of health left. Oh, what the hell was that? Did that just trigger something else? It seemed like the camera moved over to the right. But I think that was just... Yeah, that's the 3 guys over there. So I do gotta be careful, because if I move too far up, we're gonna get spotted through the windows. But this shouldn't be that hard. I think if I just use a lightning reflex shot on the mech, he's gonna be dead already, which is good. Could try and hack it, but I think, yeah, I'm not gonna do that. There we go. No action taken, 1 enemy down.
How about that?
And loot.
This looks valuable.
Yes, indeed. This looks valuable indeed. Let's see what else we can do. Emma's got a shot on the officer, but that's not amazing. Hugh, let's move you up to over here. And then I'm gonna quickly just try and hack the pole over here and see what that does. We have a lot of turns left for just an extraction from that vehicle over there, so it shouldn't be that much of a problem. Soldier immediately gains concealment, squad immediately gains concealment. And a failed hack will result in a group of enemy reinforcements being called down on your position. Interesting. Not gonna do that just yet, but it might be handy to get Hugh as a concealed unit immediately in a second. Christophe is still in concealment, which is good. And now we have Yang, who might be able to do some damage with her grenades. But first, shot-wise, this seems to be the best we can do, which isn't good. Could try another grenade, but if there's another Andromedon in the next batch, I do want to keep a few grenades handy. Although, you know what? I can move through the building if I want to. So I'm just going to blast a grenade inside of this group that is not going to kill the shield bearer or the officer, but can I do something like this? Yeah. Oh no, it doesn't. I can't destroy the officer's cover, sadly, and take out the shield bearer along with him. But I can do this. Take out the officer and his cover, and then the wall. I know I'm removing a lot of cover again, but we can move through the building if we need to. So I'm just gonna do it like this.
This is for you.
That should take care of everything. There we go, out of cover. And that should improve our shot chances dramatically. So, elite officer, I could actually just use the pistol and hope he dies, but don't really have a shot on the shield bearer otherwise. So, who else can shoot? Can't put Emma over here. Hopefully she doesn't trigger the other squad over there. The civilians are gonna run away. 82 and 79. I'm gonna go for the officer with her. And she misses that completely, but destroys the last bit of cover that was left, sadly. We still have a few troops left. 74 on the officer might be a good idea. Here we go. Thank you very much, Hugh. Much, Hugh? Jesus Christ. Thank you very much, Hugh. Much appreciated. And then, of course, the sniper rifle on the shield bearer, hopefully killing him. I need to do 7 damage to kill him. And there we go. It was even 8 because the armor blocked 1.
You know that was good.
That was very good. And now we need to be careful. I'm going to use Christophe to see how far we can get without triggering line of sight. Because I think that even if we put you, for example, I'm going to put you here to get the loot, but...
Heading to that location.
Oh, that was just next to the loot, probably. Yeah. No biggie. So I'm just going to use Christophe and see where we can find the other... What the hell is this? Half cover? There's half cover everywhere here, but that doesn't seem right. But I'm going to put him over here and see if we can't find that last squad of enemies. Now he probably spots the VIP. You. There we go.
Target identity confirmed.
Target identity confirmed. And the Andromedon and 2 Vipers spotted as well. So we're going to have to be careful because the cover might be a bit finicky in here right now because of all the explosions. If I move Ulrich over, what happens? Do they spot him through the... Oh, wow. They just spotted him through the window. Okay, fair enough. But that is actually in our advantage. Because they're moving inside of the building. Which means that they're going to keep most of the guys out of sight. I'm just going to use Emma to get the loot.
Moving to position.
There we go. And then we get expanded magazine times 2, advanced scope, which is really good. And then a normal agility PCS chip. Not that great of loot-wise, but it's something. I can get a shot on the Viper from here. gas bomb won't do anything against those guys. So I'm gonna have to be careful. I can still use the mimic beacon if I need to, which I think I'm going to do after I exhausted all my shots. Vinny actually doesn't have sight of anybody right now. So let's put him behind half cover over there. Emma could hack the pole and give us concealment, but I think with the mimic beacon it's not necessary for now. You put yourself next to the door as well. Position yourself over there. Let's open up that door and see what kind of shots we have, because I think we have a flank shot, yeah, on the Viper. So 90% with a 40% critical, or... But I think Ulrich is best suited to... Oh. I was going to say to fire at the Andromedon, but the Andromedon is out of sight. I'm going to keep his grenades for now. We might do something like this. But I think I'm going to first try Hugh's shot. Hugh, so you can see the Andromedon. Oh no, it's the other Viper. So 90% and a 40% crit chance. If you crit... the Viper is probably dead. Oh, that was even a dodge. A 2 damage dodge. What? Normally dodges have the damage, so... Why would that be... Okay then, that is stupid. I do want to use an acid bomb for the very first time, so if I can... Can I put that somewhere that... damages both the Viper and the Andromedon? Maybe over... Yeah, there. The interesting thing about the Acid Bomb, it uses the same stuff as the Andromedon contains inside of its container. So inside of the cockpit. But for some reason, the Andromedon isn't immune for that. So if I use Acid on the Andromedon, his armor will be shredded to hell. So seems like the best option for now. We have 10 turns left to get that VIP to where we want it. And there we go, 4 armor shredded. That's why that acid bomb is so powerful. And it adds a damage over time counter as well. So I'm gonna try and use Ulrich to take out the Viper, hopefully killing it this time. But I have all the faith in Ulrich. And there we go. Because yeah, Ulrich rarely misses. He's really good at those shots. Who else do we have? We have a Viper in our sights for a pistol shot. Well, we can't really do anything else, although I might actually want to move him closer. And since we're going to use the Mimic Beacon anyway, I think it's a good idea to just get Vinny closer. Is that? No, it's not cover. So let's put you over there. Oh, and we still have Emma as well. Just gonna put her on Overwatch, I think, because they're gonna try and come closer because of the Mimic Beacon. And we're gonna put the Mimic Beacon over here. There we go. And apparently Christoph is still in half cover over there, even though he's revealed. So, enemy turn. The Andromedon is probably gonna come closer. That's 2 damage from the acid burn. Oh, so that's the difference. Probably Andromedons are immune to the burn effect, so that's why they're a bit stronger against that. So since that was 2 damage, wow, 9 damage from the plasma rifle of the Andromedon. And then we have the Overwatch shot. Oh yeah, 2 damage, that's enough, he's dead. Thank you, Emma. So that only leaves the Andromedon, which is really, really good. Although I want to use Christoph and get a bit... Oh no, no, Christoph is still... is out of concealment, so that won't really help. But we can get a bit closer. I don't want to trigger anything else, but we don't really have another option. There we go. So nothing triggered. I'm going to put everybody a bit in a better position to flank the Andromedon and get a few shots in. There we go, that seems to be fine. Can't you jump through the window? Apparently you can't. Vinny is gonna have to be in a good position as well for when we actually kill the thing. This is still cover, that's so funny. But... Hugh, I think this is a good position for you. try. Let's just try our shot. 80% is actually not that good, but there we go. I think it's really cool how you can see the alien move inside the cockpit. One damage because of the miss. An 80% miss. Sorry, Ulrich, that I told everybody that you didn't miss shots. Because that kind of did the opposite. But first, 80% shot on the Andromedon from Hugh. That's 5 damage at least. Still standing. Then we have... I could use Yang, but her shots are really, really bad at the moment. I could get her really close. But that's... And Emma doesn't really have a shot anymore. So Christoph, can you run and gun? I'm gonna put you over here to get you a bit closer. And then use your shotgun to hopefully kill it. So 85% shot, but a 92% critical. So the critical chance should be very high. Please? Jesus Christ, that was... Come on, 85. Why? Shot wide. And we don't have a mimic beacon anymore, so I do need to kill this thing. So, Yang. Oh, for fuck's sake. I can't even risk it. I'm gonna have to put her over here. Absolutely. Oh, I can't even get him. Can't even get him from here. I could try and hack one of the poles. But that's just as risky, I think. Let's try and see what that's going to do. We have 9 turns left, so that's still plenty of time. Even to deal with whatever else is coming our way. 57% chance to squad immediately gains concealment. I'm gonna have to risk it, I think. Yeah. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Whew. Squad disguised signal. So I don't think anybody is... So everybody is concealed again, so that should allow us to be free of shots right now. I'm gonna put Vinny on the corner here and give him overwatch with his pistol. So he doesn't see me right now. And then overwatch with Yang as well. So, what is he going to do now? Is he just gonna... he's just going back to his original position. That is interesting. Yeah, he doesn't know where we are. There we go. Spotted flanked enemy. There we go. I don't know why Yang didn't shoot. Because he did spot us, so... Oh, and Christoph, that even works. Christoph stays in concealment. Interceptors are inbound on your current position. Firebrand has a limited window to provide extraction. So as you can see, the path that the Andromedon takes is filled with acid because he leaves that all over the place. What I do need to be careful about is since when the Andromedon dies, he's actually gonna leave an acid pool as well. So I'm not really sure how big that is, but I'm gonna move everybody out of the way just to be safe. There's the VIP. Don't think we see the other... Yeah, okay. So that's good. And the Andromedon is actually really, really close. I could move Christoph, but that removes his concealment again, and I don't really want to do that right now. So Ulrich, ready for a bit of redemption. Oh, it's still 80%, but maybe you can do something with that. That was straight in the face and a critical. 10 damage, didn't that kill it? Oh, 1 health left. Yang. 76%, that should do the trick if I'm not mistaken, but I might want to put you... Wait, why are you... You're still in concealment. So we only spotted the guy that he actually saw. Everybody else is still in concealment. That's interesting. So, Emma. Emma. Hello, Emma. What are your shot percentages? I'm just gonna... So 85. It's actually really good. Just take him out. Take him out, Emma. Earn that promotion. And another critical. Criticals all the way. So that... I think that leaves an acid pool, but I'm not really sure. And there it comes back to life. Oh my god, are you spotted? And then we have Vinny, who's of course gonna take out this Andromedon shell in 2 shots. since it's 100% on each shot, so that's 9 damage, which is really good. I think hack defense increased.
I'm busted.
Oh no, I just used ammo to fire already, so never mind. I'm just gonna use another pistol shot and hopefully kill it with that. There we go, slow motion. There we go, and it does leave a bit of an acid pool, but I think it's just the tile that it died on. So, Gustav is still in concealment, so I think most of the guys are actually in concealment. So let's try and see what else we can do here. Let's go over here to the around the outside. Yang, maybe around the outside of the building here. Hugh is also still in concealment. Really, really interesting. Interesting. My words are starting to jumble together. Babbling. Well, we're in concealment, so why not? Just gonna check the corner of the... So there's another pole over there. And I'm afraid there's something around here. Let's put you over there. Shouldn't trigger. Oh. Yeah, there we go. So that's another Andromedon with two Vipers. Which was exactly what the Shadow Chamber predicted. So are those guys gonna move? Because we gotta be careful. Once I take out the VIP... The VIP, of course, is gonna call in another squad. But the VIP is close enough to the Andromedon that they're gonna spot us the moment we try and take out the VIP. Which begs us to consider whether we shouldn't... Wait, is this window open? Because it doesn't look like I'm... Oh no, he's already out of concealment, so... I could actually engage with Ulrich already. That is... But I think we should just move everybody up for this one turn now. Before we do anything drastic.
I'm all over it.
Probably even move our concealment guys That's even permanent. Closer. So they're all out of concealment, so gotta be careful with where I put those guys.
On your order.
Let's put you over here.
En route vers la position indiquée.
What? What? He's in concealment. Oh god. Was that a glitch? Because that was the animation that they were triggered, but we're still not triggered, I suppose. That is interesting. I'm wondering if I put Ulrich over there, he's probably gonna be spotted, but yeah, the evacuation zone is close enough for me to delay this a bit, but... Yeah, I'm gonna put Ulrich over here. Vinny over here.
I'm going.
And then put everybody... No, I'm gonna reload.
I'm ready.
Hugh, I'm even gonna reload as well.
Oh, no.
Ulrich, you know what? I'm gonna reload pretty much everybody. Put Vinny on Overwatch. And that should be the turn, I think. Oh no, and Overwatch for everybody else. Never mind. Okay. Something was destroyed. But I think it's still our turn. So now, I'm gonna antagonize the group over there by putting Ulrich next to the VIP and subduing him. So through the window, probably making enough noise to trigger them as well. Oh, that didn't even... But you know what? Subdue! We never saw that because we killed the previous VIP and now we didn't see anything as well because the building is in the way.
Status confirmed. Target package in custody.
And then I think we need to... Was that an action from Ulrich? Apparently it was. We can't pick him up just yet. Yang is still in concealment as well, which is interesting. Yang, that seems to be a good position for you.
Got it.
If we trigger them right now, no biggie. That's what it is. But I'm gonna try and put everybody in a really, really close position. Maybe even too close. What? Okay, so we're revealed. So that's gonna force my hand a bit.
I'm on it.
Ooh, that wasn't what I wanted. Put fire at the Andromedon. Oh, and Yang went too far as well. That is gonna hurt. I could take out one of the Vipers immediately. That's not an issue. But I wonder why they didn't move. Could try a shot at the Andromedon. But I think it's best that I just move up already and just try. You know what? No. It's better to get the damage in right now. It's sad that I can't use Yang's acid bombs, because this is going to be a waste of time, most likely. So Hugh is still in concealment, so if I can keep him that way... Do I need to keep him that way? I don't really think I need to keep him that way, but... I do want to keep him safe, so I'm just going to put him on Overwatch. Then we have a sniper shot at the Andromedon, which could take 5 damage off of him. Combat protocol doesn't do anything extra. Although it does bypass armor. So just use combat protocol on that guy. On the Andromedon, shocking him a bit. Frying his systems. There we go, 4 damage. Through the armor. Then we have Christophe. I'm going to use him to kill one of the Vipers. Doesn't really matter which one, actually. Just going to take the closest one just to reduce the chance that one of them just flanks me. 15 damage, holy shit.
Not too shabby.
There we go. And that gives me implacable normally, and I can put myself in a better position to take cover. Because otherwise, yeah, that Viper would easily flank me over there. There we go. And then we have a sniper shot at the Andromedon. I'm wondering if the blue screen rounds already detect that it's going to be a robotic enemy. No. So that was just... I didn't reduce the hack chances. Is he gonna... Whoa! Jesus Christ! Is he gonna... Is he just gonna... Ooh, punch! He missed. Untouchable, right? Of course. Christophe is invincible after a kill. That was awesome. But the Viper's gonna do something. What? Why? Why would you take Yang? So that's interesting. Oh, he gets another shot. So Christophe is the only one that's poisoned, which is good, because we can heal that. If it's only one, we can easily heal that. Is that everything? Yeah, that's nothing, Christophe. Just take a deep breath. And there's the next batch of enemies.
Menace 1-5, we're picking up an enemy transport inbound on your current position.
So I really, really want to take out that Andromedon on this turn. Christophe is in a poison cloud, so the first thing I want to do is move him out of it. Because he has the best chances to get that Viper out of the way. Is that a window? It does seem like I should be able to kill him from over here. Although that block might actually just be blocking him. Just move him out of the way for now.
I can handle that.
Because he was poisoned already. Then put... What can we do? Hugh is still in concealment for some reason. But if I'm gonna heal, does healing actually break concealment? Doesn't seem like it does. So heal Christophe and see what happens, because I think we get another action after that. Yeah, that didn't break concealment. That is interesting. Because I'm actually wide out in the open. Good fire at the Andromedon, don't want to do that. Because Ulrich has armor piercing rounds. Which of course is really good. But... Huh. That only does 6 to 8 damage, of course. So... I want to be smart about this. I want to put Yang in a position so she can fire at the incoming enemies. But they're far away. Jesus Christ. Should put her over here on the... Or maybe even up here. Let's see what we can do. I think if I use Ulrich first... Ulrich has Shredder and he has armor piercing rounds. So if he hits... That should be... I can actually take the VIP with me already. Just gonna do that first, because that doesn't... I'm not sure if that takes an action. If it does, it does. But I don't think it does. Oh, I can't fire if I have a VIP with me. So Ulrich, go over there. You can vault over things, but you can't fire your too heavy weapon, probably. I can't fire, so I'm gonna put down the unit. And then hopefully I can try and fire again. No. God damn it, I can't fire then. So putting down a unit is an action. I'm gonna have to use the acid bomb then. So there we go. Should have put her in a better position, but I kind of forgot about that. Never mind. Let's just break all that and destroy his armor. There we go. Blanketing the area with acid. Not that the Andromedon cares, but now what we can do is use Hugh to get a shot in. But that's really dangerous because he's wide out in the open. Christoph, I want to use him to just take out the Viper over here. To just put you in a running gun. And then put you over here, most likely. Yeah, there we go. Now we should have a 100% shot at the Viper, taking him out with ease. Goodbye. Join your friend in the Viper afterlife.
You know that was good.
Yeah, that was very good. So now we get Implacable, which should allow us to get even closer for the next turn. Because he's also invincible for any attacks. Oh, we can't actually see the Andromedon from here. That is interesting. But, Emma, my girl. Can you kill that Andromedon for me? Can you kill that Andromedon for me? You know what? I'm gonna first try Hugh's shot. 88. That's 5 damage, which is good, I think. 4 damage left. Okay, that's really good. So now I can guaranteed use combat protocol and kill it with that. Well, the suit, that is. The guy inside, that is. There we go. And I was gonna come back to life. But we still have Vinny, and he should have 2 pistol shots because lightning reflexes has returned. So, Vinny, over here.
Whatever you say.
And it's the only guy that I have left. So if this fails, I'm gonna probably get hit in the face by an Andromedon. So lightning hands. Then forget it this time. So 9 damage, and I think we need another 9 damage. Yeah. To take it out, so please no 8. 8 is the only thing you can't do. Oh, thanks. Thank God. Holy shit.
Impressed yet?
4 turns left. 4 turns left to get to the evacuation zone. And there's reinforcements on the way. Hoping that's not too bad. That's just... I see a Lancer and a Duper, I think. And an officer. So that's not that bad. I can take care of that normally. Yes, you're not the only one who sees them. I think everybody sees them. So they're moving, yeah, defensive positions, of course. I could probably take out the Lancer. Yes, you're an asshole too. So yeah, I could take out the Lancer from over here. So that's not a problem. Ulrich... He still has grenades left, so I'm wondering how far we can get those. Oh, and I left... Oh, fuck. I left a VIP over there on the floor. But we don't have need for any... Oh, that is actually a really good one. We don't really have any need for cover anymore, since we're just getting really close to killing all these guys. So let's just use a grenade on those. I'm gonna use Yang to pick up the VIP again, because we're close enough to do that. Oh, the trooper is almost dead, but not completely. What are your sword attacks? I'm really wondering about that now. 99 and 89. I just want to be sure that I kill whatever I want to kill. Because that means that Christoph is invulnerable for the next turn. Yang, you're gonna have to... Oh, you know what? Vinny's not really useful anymore at this point, shooting-wise. Could have used the sniper rifle, but I mean, it's better that he just uses his abilities to carry the VIP with me and go to the extraction zone from over here then, probably. Then we have Yang. She's out of grenades, but she could get a nice shot at something from over there. Emma's actually quite a ways back, and Hugh as well. I'm gonna have to be careful with that, because I could put Hugh over here and see what shots we have. We're immune. Oh, because of the new armor, we're probably immune to... Oh, was that the poison? Oh yeah, he's immune to poison because he's carrying a medkit. He could fire, but how far are we away from the... Ooh. From the extraction zone. I do need to be careful with that as well. Could fire on the Lancer, but it's not really necessary for now. I could actually sword slash the officer, but that's not going to kill him, right? No. It's 99, which is good. But I'm not going to be able to kill him from over there. What else do we have? 73 on the trooper, 65 on the Lancer for some reason. That's really bad shots for where you're standing. So yeah, Hughes, we have 3 turns after this to get you to the evac zone, so that shouldn't be a problem. Thank you for the kill! So that's one enemy less. Then we're gonna use Yang to try and take out the trooper. That sounds like a hit. Okay. Whew. That trooper didn't care for the first 2 seconds of fire entering its body. Then Emma, move you up all the way over here.
Running.
Then we have Christophe. I do want to get a shot in at the officer. What are your shots right now? So getting closer wouldn't really help that. But I'm going to use a sword attack. The reason for that is he's probably going to get hit. But if I do it from over here, he's going to be forced to move. Because he doesn't want to get flanked by Christophe. But yeah, just try that. How many health? How much health do you have? Oh, that's plenty. I know he's going to get damaged. I'm really aware of that. But that gets Christophe close to the evac zone as well. So let's just try and do that. 99%. If that misses, I'm gonna 2 damage for a dodge.
Barely registered.
Seriously, yeah, barely registered indeed. So now he's gonna move. Oh, he's gonna move. Wow. Overwatch. Well, I got bad news for you, officer. I'm immune for Overwatch. Well, specifically, Christophe has Shadow Step, so that means he doesn't trigger Overwatch. So if I move him over here, he's gonna have a very, very nice shot on the officer here. Goodbye. Overwatch removed. Yeah, I think more than that was removed.
Well,
so that gives
that?
Me implacable.
Over here.
Being able to move back towards the evac zone, which is really, really
no
good.
Problem,
and then we're gonna just move everybody in the evac zone.
Been
and there's the last one. There we go. Evacuated successfully without even any damage because the officer didn't fire for some reason.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Did we get wounded? What? Oh yeah, the poison on Christophe. Yeah, okay. But that was healed rather quickly. I don't think he's going to be out from that. Because the armor protected him against it. So, Vinny dealt most damage, even though he wasn't there for most of the encounters. But he killed both of the Andromedons with his EMP rounds. And then Ulrich made most attacks. Wow, look at Emma, how happy she is. Christophe was on the fire most, but again moved the furthest as well, because he's getting a lot of mileage out of his ranger abilities, because that was really, really nice again. Not that great of a successful shot percentage, could be better, but there we go. So back home, let's kick back and relax and check out our promotions, because I think we have a few.
After a mission like that, spirits are going to be high around here.
There we go. He is wounded for 5 days. Seriously, that was 1 damage. That's ridiculous. Let's promote. And now Now Vinny is gonna be a beast. Face off, fire once at every visible enemy with your pistol. That is gonna come in handy really, really, really soon. There we go. Face off. And then we have Ulrich's new ability. He's almost at the end, isn't he? Yeah, so salvo, launching or throwing grenades or using heavy weapons with your first action will not end your turn, which is really, really powerful. Or hail of bullets. Unleash a hail of bullets that is guaranteed to hit your target but uses a lot of ammunition. So we could go for a guaranteed hit or two actions that we can take as long as we don't move. I think the first one is just... I mean, that means that we can fire a grenade and then fire again if we want to. Along with his amazing grenades and everything else that he's gone through. This is going to be one hell of a grenadier. So Ulrich, congratulations on your salvo ability. There we go. And then we have, of course, a captured VIP. Nat Armstrong. So Nathan, probably Armstrong. Two expanded magazine, an advanced scope, and a PCS for agility. So 13 dodge added to the soldier we give that to.
Your efforts continue to bolster the resistance movement across the globe.
A whopping 177 supplies and 90 intel. So that's going to come in handy because we're building another resistance comms as well. So that's going to allow us to, well, make contact with a lot of areas. So let's go back to the bridge. I don't think there's anything else of interest at the moment. Alien alloys and crystals, that's starting to be really, really interesting at this moment. But I think we were also making contact. So I think we're going to go there first, make contact, and then we're going to head to that cave. So we're still researching the black side file, so that's going to complete as well. And the experimental armor will be completed as well. So making contact.
Setting course for Sector 5.
That's really a no-brainer, but we're getting low on Illyrium, so that's gonna need that for the other plasma weapons. So yeah, I really want that cave as well. So two
communications facility now operational.
So that's really good. I'm gonna, for now, carry on, but no, I'm gonna ignore that, carry on, and put that that engineer in the shielding the power core over here, so that just boosts that a bit, because for now we don't need the extra contacts. We have one extra, so no need to spend an engineer on that. There we go, continue making contact. Experimental armor probably. There we go, hazmat vest. By reinforcing the nanoscale vest with specialized in materials, soldiers gain an additional health boost and are completely resistant to any environmental hazards like fire, acid or poison. Really, really powerful, because in XCOM Enemy Unknown and Enemy Within, the Titan armor, so the last armor you get, made you actually immune for those specific things. But now the last armor doesn't do that, so we still need those extra vests. I'm gonna give that to Yang in a minute, once we get a new mission, but let's make contact first. Oh.
Still can't believe it's come to this.
Oh yeah, right, so that's the completion of the black side file.
Are the worst of what we find today.
They're slaughtering us, Doctor. What could be worse?
We're about to find out. I've patched the Shadow Chamber directly into the ship's computer. It's been sifting through the material we recovered non-stop since our return, cataloging sequences.
Genetic sequences, in near infinite combinations, yet all bearing similar genetic markers. Human markers.
There must be thousands of them.
Tens of thousands. And the procedure is still nowhere near complete.
Which is why we need the ship's computer to find out where they came from. By cross-referencing them with the data we've managed to hack from the Advent Network. It's an admission file from one of the gene therapy clinics.
Avatar. Just what exactly is in that vial?
In my worst nightmares, I would never have imagined.
Doctor.
I believe we have found the missing civilians.
That's impossible.
The gene clinics. Millions of people just looking for help.
Medically screened and selected. Suitable candidates taken to that contemptible facility to be processed, refined into the material we now possess.
But why do this?
I could not begin to fathom a guess at this point. There exists no research that would ever warrant this.
It's genocide, Doctor. And these people are walking right into it. We may not know what they're doing with this stuff, but I think I can find out where it's going. Got it. It's a high security production facility. Standard defensive complement.
Then I strongly suggest we pay them a visit, Commander.
And that we Agreed. Will, Bradford. That we will.
The information we gain could prove invaluable towards stopping the aliens' true agenda.
New objective added.
So long story short, they're melting humans into this genetic goo. So that was contained in the black side vial. Which is actually really interesting. They're acting all surprised, but we saw that happening when we entered the facility. We saw containers with humans being dipped into a pool of acid, so they kind of knew what was going on. It's of course a revelation that was that those people were the missing people from the gene therapy clinics, but you could have easily made that connection already. But complete the Blackside Vial coordinates mission, another mission that would reduce the Avatar project significantly, because that black side file has something to do with the Avatar project, of course.
Objectives based on the latest findings.
So my initial curiosity and excitement regarding our earlier discoveries involving the recovered alien datum have been all but extinguished by the disturbing results of my latest tests. Having analyzed the composition of the green-hued substance retrieved from the Advent black side, I can only draw one conclusion, that the facility was designed solely for the refinement and production of concentrated genetic material, human genetic material. With the entirety of our ship's systems dedicated to my analysis, I found that the single vial we recovered contains the unique human genomes of over 1 million subjects. 1 million people convinced to join Advent Cities out of desperation, then subjected to appalling experiments that eventually cost them their lives. To what end, I can only imagine. And that's of course what we're gonna try and find out. I can't check anything. I could decrypt the codex data, but I do want to have some other research going first. So let's go over there, new research.
Hello,
and Commander. Select. I think we're gonna go for beam cannons right now, because yeah, that's gonna be a really nice upgrade. So beam cannons.
I assumed you'd make that research a priority, Commander.
Yeah,
I'll
right.
Notify
you would.
You as soon as the report is available.
So back to the bridge.
Commander,
and there we go, mission locked. We need to
forge facility, but we'll still need to establish contact with the local resistance forces before we can move in to investigate.
So that's why I've been boosting our resistance comms so heavily. So we upgraded one resistance comms and we made another one, because we need to make contact with at least three more regions to get both of those missions going. But continue making contact. There we go. That unlocks another alien facility that we can raid in case the Avatar project is coming to completion. But for now, just make contact with those people and give us those extra supplies.
Signal's coming through clear.
So 92 supplies extra, and I want to make that into an tower as well. But the interesting thing is that I do want to get that cave first. Supply drop in a day, that's going to be annoying as well, because that means the cave is going to start disappearing after our supply drop. But let's just head towards that cave and try and get at least something out of it, because our Illegium is really running dry.
Incoming,
and we haven't seen any, so that's supply drop already.
Now.
Your progress against the aliens over the past month has been significant, Commander. But there is still room to improve if we are going to eliminate the alien threat.
Why is there room to improve? We completed every mission we got. We got our guerrilla operations completed, two cancel missions, one region contacted, and one three rumors investigated. So that's not that bad, I would say. We didn't blow anything up, but it's handy nonetheless. The Viper round's getting really, really close, and the next retaliation strike is imminent. So we're gonna get that in the next few days. A resistance informant isn't really that annoying, but the hidden event, do I want to waste a bit of intel to check that out? I'm going to have to wait with that. So let's continue and investigate the supply drop. We have not finished scanning at this location, that is
Avenger
true, but
new
supplies are more important. There we go, there it is. View retaliation site. Do I need to buy any more items? I'm gonna have to check that out. But 11 enemies and another unknown enemy. So a heavy mech, elite trooper, elite shield bearer, and advanced officer. And actually thinking what we're gonna encounter now. Not really sure. There might be another enemy type that I'm missing, but I think I know what's gonna be in the mission. But we'll see that in the next episode. But first, let's configure our squad a bit, because I want to make a few changes. Because we only have advanced max, which means that I do want to have Christoph. Christoph, there we go. And what I want to change is the Skulljack is going to be really handy, but I want to use our best troops on this, because retaliation strikes, we need to handle that really, really quickly. So let's check out the loadout of Emma, make the Skulljack available again, and then let's just remove her from the squad for now and put Benito back in. And then I'm hesitating. Do I need a Hugh? I don't think I do, so I'm gonna remove him and then just go for... There's actually two options here. I could go for Cedric, give ourselves another sharpshooter and take out as much as we can alongside with the... Gives us a bit of mobility, but I think Jazz is the better option just to give us another ranger. So I'm gonna edit him as well and give him the... not the hazmat vest. I can't give him an extra grenade. That's not bad, because I'm gonna actually swap this out a bit. So first, Yang, I'm gonna give you the hazmat vest. There we go. Do I need to give you a PCS chip? We have a few. I know, we only have the Dodge. So I think Jazz and Christoph have PC. Oh no. So I'm gonna give Jazz the Dodge chip. Aided Christoph and remove the Mimic Beacon. I'm gonna give the Mimic Beacon back to Jazz and give Christoph a gas bomb, if I'm not... Why can't I give you the Skulljack? That is weird. Gas bomb or incendiary bomb? Maybe incendiary bomb. That might be cool. Because there's a lot of normal troopers running around, apparently. And then we're gonna edit Benito again as well. Give him the Skulljack. And what else was there? Could give him a little grenade, but... Actually, poison might come in handy with all those troopers, so let's just give him a poison grenade. Then Jazz the Mimic Beacon. So let's give him that. There we go. Do we have another opening? I don't think we have, right? We have everything we want with us. But I want to check out the upgrade. So I think if I... Don't really need to change your scope, because your scope is pretty good. So the only thing I do want to change is the loadout of Yang, because Yang doesn't really have anything on her weapons. So an expanded magazine would be cool. So one added or three added. The superior expanded magazine is cool, but I want to save that for somebody else. I'm going to give you a scope. Do I want to give you a scope? I'm going to give you a scope. There we go. And then one just a normal expanded magazine. There we go. So giving you a bit of extra firepower. Then Benito's weapon. Do you need anything else? I think I'm going to give you a bit of an expanded magazine. There we go. Fixing that up. And then... the last thing I want to do, because we got the extra supplies now, so I'm going to build actually another... Well, we're going to build the plasma rifles. Nothing else I need, I think, so just a plasma rifle. There we go. And now, look at Benito's weapon. That plasma rifle is really, really nice. So, two storm guns, sniper rifle with EMP rounds, a plasma rifle, and two grenadiers. So that should... do the trick. But before we head into the retaliation mission, I'd like to thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe, because I really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye. Yeah,